The cycloaddition reactions that we saw in the last webcast are an example of a pericyclic reaction, and in this webcast we'll continue to look at other photoinduced pericyclic reactions. First, the sigmatropic rearrangement, and then we'll look at the electrocyclic ring opening and ring closing reactions. Let's begin with the sigmatropic rearrangement. Normally, if we would see a substrate like this, a 1,5 diene, we would begin to think about a 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement, and that's indeed what takes place under thermal conditions. If we heat this molecule up, the 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement takes place by the curved arrows that I'm showing you here, so that the dideuterosubstituted carbon attaches to this dicyanosubstituted carbon and makes the new bond that's shown in the product here. From the curved arrows, specifically that there are three curved arrows to describe the process, we know that there are a total of 6 electrons involved in the 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. Now let's take a look at what happens under photochemical conditions. We see a different product is formed. It's the result of a 1,3 sigmatropic rearrangement rather than a 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. Curved arrow convention can be used to describe the flow of electrons for this 1,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. We'll start with the sigma bond that breaks. It adds into the pi bond, and the pi bond moves over. You can see from the fact that there are two curved arrows that only 4 electrons are involved in this photochemical 1,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. Because this is a photochemical process, we can anticipate that the frontier orbitals involved would be a HOMO to HOMO star type interaction. The curved arrows suggest that the key orbitals involved would be a sigma orbital and a pi orbital. And so we could anticipate then a supraphacial sigma to HOMO star, or in other words, sigma to pi kind of interaction. This three-dimensional model will help give you a better feeling for the orbital interactions that are involved. Let me show you the chair of this six-membered ring. The chair form of the six-membered ring is outlined here, and notice that the sigma bond that's involved has an axial substituent which lies above the plane of this pi bond. So what we need to do in order to promote this 1,3 sigmatropic suprafacial reaction is to have that sigma bond donate its electrons onto the lobe of the pi bond that's shown here. This overlap is possible because in the excited state, a new geometry of the double bond will be obtained, one that involves twisting about the carbon-carbon double bond. Now let's take a look at the electrocyclic ring closure reaction for this 1,3 diene shown here. 4 pi electrons are involved in the electrocyclic ring closure process, and previously we learned that under thermal conditions, the pathway that's followed for a 4 pi electrocyclic ring closure reaction is the conrotatory pathway. For this particular reactant, where the methyl groups are shown, that would give us, by the conrotatory pathway, the transisomer, where one methyl group is above the plane of the newly formed 4-membered ring, and one methyl group is below the plane of the newly formed 4-membered ring. Under photochemical conditions, this same reactant gives a different isomer. It gives the cis isomer, and the only way that this can come about is by a disrotatory process. How can we rationalize that under photochemical conditions the disrotatory pathway is going to be followed? Well, we're going to use some of the very same ideas that we previously used to rationalize the thermal case, the only difference being that under photochemical conditions the key orbital interactions, the key frontier orbital interactions, are going to involve HOMO interacting with HOMO star. Just as we did, though, in the thermal case, where the new pi bond forms, we're going to set the phases to be matched for those HOMO-HOMO star orbitals that are involved. And so in the back, we're going to position the lobes there on the two carbons where the new pi bond forms to have phases that are matched. And then we'll fill in to make HOMO and HOMO star, which is of course identical to HOMO. And then what we need to realize is that in order to make the connection, the orbital overlap between the matched phases, we're going to need to rotate one of the atoms in the clockwise direction and the other one in the counterclockwise direction. That's the disrotatory process, and when we do that, one methyl group comes up and the other methyl group will come up to give us the cis isomer that we saw. This table summarizes the pathway of allowed electrocyclic ring opening and ring closure reactions depending upon the number of electrons that are involved. The example that we just looked at was a 4π electrocyclic reaction, meaning that it was a 4q process where q is equal to 1. Under thermal conditions, the reaction followed the conrotatory pathway, while under photochemical conditions, it followed the disrotatory pathway. Once we see that the trends that we learned for thermal processes are just reversed for photochemical. And this holds true for all of the 4q plus 2 electron substrates as well.